She's so dramatic, post a caption, I say no regrets. But that's just to cover up, I know the truth, I lied to tech. Yeah. You slept on me, collected Z's, and now that keep you up at night. That should keep you up at night. Oh, oh. I see.
Welcome to episode 4. It's a beautiful day today. The sun is shining, we have a pre-workout, we eat breakfast, and we're on our way to the gym before work. You know what, I want to start off the video by just showing you the physique right here in this lighting from outside, because this is actually sick. The physique is looking on point today. I'm not gonna explain it, I'm just gonna show you.
Okay, so hopefully you can see we have the natural lighting from outside, which is very sick. We weighed in at 78.7 this morning, and just, I don't know if you can see it, but look how veiny we are, man. You can see the striations in the shoulder, triceps, and when I do like this, hopefully you can see it, but you can see the veins on the stomach are starting to come through, which is sick. So the shape is really getting there. This is really good.
We're going to have a team gathering with Team Live Fit. So we have like these team gatherings where we practice on posing like every other Sundays, and they help a lot. And the team have two coaches who run the team, and if you want coaching, you can use them. They're doing a very good job. And today I'm going there at 6 o'clock, but we're having a gym. I'm having a push day at the gym where we're going to have the team gathering before the posing. So just gonna. So that really made me happy that we actually look so good right now. Cause after a push day and we get the pump in our chest, shoulders, and triceps, we're gonna look insane today on the posing. So I'm very excited about that. I was actually a bit anxious this morning because I had eaten my breakfast, and then I sat down and waited for like 2 to 3 hours, and then I ate a banana because I was starting to get hungry and I didn't want to eat my pre-workout meal that early. And then like suddenly out of nowhere I just got this crazy craving for apples, which is pretty weird. I guess I was just craving something sweet, but and sometimes apples have given me like made my stomach irritated, and I was standing there thinking, okay, do not eat that apple, it's just gonna upset your stomach. And I'm just standing there and I'm like, fuck it. So I grabbed the apple, ate it, and then I instantly regretted it. But as you saw on the footage right now, my stomach didn't get upset by it, luckily. So I've learned my lesson. If I get a craving for an apple again, like, just don't do it. It ain't worth the risk. But today we didn't get bloated from the apple, but it ain't worth the risk.
Like, what the fuck, who gets cravings for an apple? Like, it's freaking weird.
So I actually have two board shorts. This is the blue one, this one from Gymshark, and this one is from Syn Elite, I think that's how you say it. But this one is actually made for men's physique competitions. So as you can see, it's a bit longer than this one, and it's way more tight around my quads. I think I probably will go for the black one on the competition. I'm not sure. I might buy some other ones just to try some different one out. I know Alphalete, or Christian Guzman, said in one of his videos that Alphalete will be launching some board shorts again soon. So I really hope that, because I want to buy some board shorts from Alphalete too and try them on. But like you can see, the blue color, like, it looks very good, but I feel like everyone is wearing blue and it's a little bit boring to wear the same as everyone. But like, so here we have the blue Gymshark one. You know, it's okay, but it's very loose and I don't think it's long enough, because it's supposed to go down to your knees somewhere around here. So
we have a lot of room here, but I really like the color.
Here we have the other one, the black one from Synelite, and as you can see, the fit is way better.
It's a little bit too tight around the quads, but
I will drop a lot of weight, so it will probably fit perfectly once I lose some more weight. And you can see here, it's good around the glutes and everything. You know, this color is probably better, but I mean, everyone has blue, and I actually think this one looks pretty sick. So, I don't know. Which one do you guys like best? Comment down below.
Jag har nog sagt att det är jämbra med dig som jag kan pumpa lite. Så.
Favoritmaskinen den här alltså. This is the gym where we have the team gathering with the posing, and as you can see, there are literally no people there, so that's freaking awesome. Easy for us to film. Guys, I'm actually very happy right now. Me and Örjan, the guy you saw earlier, we went to the team gathering and we had a push workout before the posing session. And afterwards, we had the posing. And oh, hold on. Funny how it went. And like that actually went very well. I'm struggling with like bringing up my lats, but they helped me a lot, and like one of the coaches, she was like touching my lats and like to bring them forward, and it was like boom, it was like night and day of the shoulder to waist ratio, like it changed so much just by her like touching the lats and activating them. It was like we looked way bigger, so that made me very happy, like to see how much posing actually can do to your physique and how much like the stage presence has to do with overall how you look. So also I talked with Frederick, one of the coaches, after a team gathering, and he gave me some very good advice. You know, he said that we were very lean and like almost ready for stepping on stage like in 2-3 weeks, and we are 10 weeks, maybe 9 weeks out now. It's like 69 days at least out, and we're this lean already. So, and that was really comforting for me to hear, because you guys, you've seen my physique, you know, I look very lean, but in my head, I feel that I don't have a lot of time, even though it's 10 weeks. I feel like I have, don't have that much time, which is fucked up to think, but like, but when he told me that we looked good, we were en route, and we like, we were, that just made me relax and like, okay, whew, we're actually, we have good, we have a lot of time on us and things are looking good, and we're maybe going a bit too fast, but like, yeah, we've been rambling for very long, but yeah. We're en route. I thought I haven't done a refeed day or anything, or cheat meal, this entire prep, like, so I thought today I bought a pizza. So what I'm going to do now is that I'm going home and I'm going to eat my 3,000 calories, like what I'm supposed to do. And then after I eat all my meals, I'm going to eat this afterwards. And this pizza is 700 calories, which means I will end up at 3,700 calories today. So it's not something sick, like I'm just eating one extra pizza throughout the day. So, but like, I just wanted to celebrate since I'm so happy now and things are going as planned. And
it is time, guys. I'm super excited now. Okay, okay.
Are you ready?
Oh, look at this. So we have oatmeal with the white chocolate topping and blueberries and this delicious pizza.
I'm also watching some Christian Guzman summer shredding. So
perfect that they upload a video right now.
This is actually the first refeed day I've done. I'm gonna be incorporating them maybe once a week or maybe once every second week. But my plan now is that since I've been staying at 3,000 calories, I'm gonna bump them up to 3,200, 3,300, see how that affects my body. But for now, here are the calories from today. Yeah, there you can see 3,710, and as you can see, our normal macros are 3,000, but you can see here that most of the calories that I added today on the refeed is carbs. Like, we kept the fat and the protein almost the same. They're a bit above, but that's the most important thing to do when you do a refeed, is to get them carbs in. But very excited to see how this affects my body today. So we'll probably look sick tomorrow, but now I'm gonna eat because I'm looking so forward to this. It is pretty late now. I'm actually going to sleep now, but I just been thinking a little bit, so I just wanted to talk to you guys right now. And what I wanted to talk about is that like right now, regarding this competition, I actually felt like I didn't have that much time left. But so as you notice, we are pretty lean 10 weeks out from the competition, but like, I didn't feel like I had that much time. But you know, I realized that we have 10 weeks and we're pretty lean already. Like, that's what I realized today when I was talking to the coaches and everything. And I haven't necessarily been dropping weight too fast, but I have just been starting the cut too early. So that isn't a problem. That just means that we have more time and we're able to do diet breaks and lay a bit higher on the calories. But for me, this just means that my current calories are 3,000. But tomorrow I will switch them up to 3,300, and I won't be stressing that much like I've been doing now, because I've been feeling like I don't have that much time and it's been stressing me. But today I realized we have 10 weeks, we have good time. Like, we're almost ready for the show now, so I should just bump up my calories even more and don't stress so much about it. So that was actually good to find, to hear, like, to know that, to actually understand that we have more time. So I'm actually gonna do it right now. I'm gonna take up my phone and I'm adjusting my calories to 3,300. Here you can see, there we go. So believe it or not, I'm actually like, it's stressing me out that I have to adjust them, because it feels like, increasing calories, but feels good. I've shown you guys. Yeah. Like we have veins on our stomach, as you could see on the clip this early this morning, and like there's no reason to rush it and do it too quickly. So 3,300 calories at the moment, and I will also, I think I will be doing refeed maybe once a week or once every second week, but I don't need stress, man. Well, I'm stressing too much. We have a good time. So yeah, I'm excited to see like how fast we will lose weight when I increase my calories now. If you're still watching now, you're an MVP, man. I love you. So thank you for listening to me. But now I'm going to bed and waking up at 8 o'clock tomorrow. I have the late night, no, the afternoon shift, so I will be working out early tomorrow. So. Day after the refeed or cheat, that is to be expected, of course. We ate a lot more carbs than we usually do, so we will hold a little bit water and weigh a bit more, so it will probably go back down to where we was like in 1 or 2 days. So not gonna stress about that, because your weight will probably go up a bit the day after refeed.
So me and Vims are currently just chilling here. He's keeping me with company, right? Yeah. He's such a cutie. Snid Vims. This is life. Just came home from work. I have 2 days off now. Then I have 2 days, Friday and Saturday, with work, and then we have 3 weeks with vacation, which means we can upload a lot in those 3 weeks. So looking very forward to that vacation. You're leaving me, bro. Don't you dare.
So I'm actually editing this video right now, and what I wanted to tell you guys now is like something crazy happened today. This is currently 3 days after our refeed day, and as I told you guys, our calories were at 3,000 calories, and I understood that, okay, we need to increase our calories because we're losing weight too quickly with 3,000. So increase them from 3,000 to 3,300. And the day after our refeed day, where we ate 3,700 calories, I went in at 79.7. And today, 3 days later, we have done our refeed. We have increased our calories to 3,300. I got a new low weigh-in today. I went in at 78 kilos today. What the fuck? That doesn't make any sense. Did my body really respond that well to the refeed? It's crazy. So I think I might have to increase my calories even more. It's a bit too early to tell. I will keep eating 3,000 calories and then check later how my body reacts. But so far, it almost looks like the refeed day just kicked off our metabolism or something, because this is just crazy. This vlog has been very long right now, and I just wanted to tell that I want these episodes of Road to Sanofi Open to be like I want to go a bit more deep and like tell you guys how I feel, and like not just talk about what I'm going to eat, what I'm going to do, but I want to like tell you guys how life is going, what is happening to me, and how I feel about certain things, and like keep things real and let you guys actually know the real me. So there will probably be more videos like this where I talk to the camera and like go in depth and explain how I feel and like what goes inside of my head, and like you get to know the real Christopher, not just like, oh, we're gonna eat some oatmeal, oh, we're going to work out, if you understand. So I want to thank you guys so much for watching this episode. I'm really happy about my upload frequency. As you can see, I've been uploading much more frequently now than I've been earlier in my YouTube career. So I'm doing it for you guys. I want to bring you guys the best content you can have. And but guys, enough rambling. Hit the subscribe button, give the video a like to help me out, motivate me. So thank you guys so much for watching. See you guys in the next video. I need something like a blank check. Spending a lot of emotion on tonight. Don't you hit me with a rain check. No need to make it a train wreck. Find me a time and decide soon. Cause I'll be on my way.